For the week of April 18th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15. Your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Fleet Activities Yokosuka recently received a new tug, YT-805 Seminole. Two more tugs will join Seminole to replace five older model tugs at CFAY.
Some of the vessels are as old as 49 years old, and it's more or less just out with the old and in with the new and getting the updated technology and things that are being out there for today's Navy.
The new tugs bring more horsepower, upgraded radar and electronics, which will modernize the tug fleet. The new tugs will streamline the more than 400 ship movements in and out of CFAY each year.
Our old tugboats are 2,000 horsepower, and the new tugboats will be 4,000 horsepower, which is going to give us increased capability here in Yokosuka, because with the current length to get George Washington away or Blue Ridge away, we have to order in commercial tugs. But now with these upgraded, these commercial grade tugs that we have, we'll be able to conduct these operations ourselves without having to use commercial tugs.
The tug's name, Seminole, also speaks to the ship's strength.
Naval tradition is that tugboats were named after Indian tribes. So what we did is we took two of our tugboats that are going to be decommed. They're actually made up of the five Indian tribes that made up the Seminole Nation. And also Seminole means wild horse. So with it having 4,000 horsepower compared to 2,000 horsepower, we thought it was a good fit for the first tug.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
It's been several weeks since the 9.0 earthquake and tsunami devastated the northeastern coast of Japan, and the U.S. military continues to provide disaster relief and assistance as part of Operation Tomodachi. As soon as the disaster struck, ships from Yokosuka Naval Base recalled all personnel and set out to help, leaving Yokosuka relatively empty. Ships have started to return now, and the sailors say they're glad they could help. Seaman William Stedham is new to the Navy, but not new to natural disasters.
I felt very good about it. I really enjoy doing this mission. It's very difficult for the Japanese, but I was personally on the other side of this. I was in New Orleans when Katrina hit, so I kind of know firsthand what these people are going through, and I feel really good about helping them.
Stedham's ship, guided missile destroyer USS Fitzgerald, was one of the first to leave, and the commanding officer, Commander Dennis Velez, says they may be back, but it doesn't mean they're done.
We're standing by, if it's more disaster relief operations or just presence ops and 7th Fleet operations, and all the other missions that we do on a day-to-day basis. So the ship's ready, the crew's ready, they're very happy that we were able to help, and we're standing by to provide more help if needed.
Petty Officer Brandon Shelander, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Fleet Activities Yokosuka Command Master Chief Gregory Vidari met with the Japanese spouse group to address questions over voluntary departures and other issues resulting from the March 11th earthquake.
Our family members back here, they have questions, they have concerns, and one of the things that helps ease that is communication. And that's probably one of the key things about me being here today is I'm going to be able to communicate directly with these Japanese spouses to tell them, to provide them with answers that they're looking for.
Understanding directions and procedures in English can be difficult for some spouses with a different primary language.
There's a lot of spouses that cannot understand English really well. You know, they can communicate with their husbands, but sometimes it's kind of hard to understand what other English-speaking people are saying. So we kind of help them, we help each other, give them information.
For many spouses, direct communication with the command was very helpful.
You know, a lot of people have Japanese spouses, and we look at Japanese news too, but we also get information from base, and so we're getting from both sides, and sometimes it's very confusing, and so to hear from Command Master Chief himself is very kind of like reassuring, a lot of things, and I think a lot of spouses appreciate it.
For more information, contact the Fleet and Family Support Center. Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.